Hey guys, thanks for tuning back into Cooking with Jen. I'm Jen. That's Prince.
And Shelby.
Alright, so today we're going to be making for you one of my favorites, Italian meatloaf. Now, it's a great meal to make. I'm going to make it on a Sunday afternoon, so that tomorrow we can have leftovers. So when I'm tired from coming home from work, homeschooling the kids, I have leftovers I can just heat up and we're good to go. For my Italian meatloaf, I've got about 1.5 to 2 pounds. And you're gonna wanna do a meatloaf mixture, which is ground pork and ground beef. To that, I'm going to add 1 egg. A little garlic powder, onion powder. Now, if you like, you can do some diced onions. I'm not a huge fan of onions, but I do like the flavor, so that's why I just use the onion powder. I'm gonna add parsley flakes, a little oregano, and then this is an Italian meatloaf, so we are gonna add an Italian seasoning mixture. Now, I like to add some Parmesan cheese right into my meat. Now, I'm gonna give you a little tip. This is almost the exact same way I make my meatballs. I use that same mixture. The only difference is I don't add diced tomatoes to my meatballs, which I am gonna add to this mixture. Now, I have a can of diced tomatoes, which I have drained. Now, I'm only gonna add about half of my can because I'm gonna save the rest to add on top. Now, we're making Italian meatloaf. I bet you're wondering, where's the breadcrumbs? Instead of breadcrumbs, what I do, and I do this for my meatballs too, I take some bread. Now, I happen to be using Italian bread today, but even if you have white bread at home, you can use that same thing. I like to dip it in milk. Then all you need to do, you crumble it in. Now what this does, it's gonna keep your meatloaf moist as it's cooking.
Rain, I clear it out. I let it rain, I clear it out. I let it rain, I clear it out. I let it rain.
Now you wanna make sure you squeeze the excess milk out of that bread. And you go ahead and leave that crust on the bread. This helps add to the flavor. I've got everything in my bowl. Now it's time to get your hands dirty. You're gonna mix it with your hands. As you can see, we have mixed this up really well. And you might be thinking to yourself, I don't have a meatloaf pan. How can I make meatloaf? Well, guess what? I don't either. You don't need a meatloaf pan. You can use a baking dish. So what I'm gonna do with this mixture, I'm gonna mold it. Look at that. No meatloaf pan needed. You're just gonna mold it with your hands. And because you put that egg in there, it's gonna help keep everything together and it's gonna help you mold it. I have my oven preheated to 350 degrees. And what I'm gonna add a little beef stock to it. If you don't have any kind of stock, you can use water. All it's for, mainly is to keep the moisture in your meatloaf so it doesn't dry out. I also am gonna cover it. I like to keep it covered for the majority of the time it's cooking. Like I said, it's gonna keep all those juices in. And I'm gonna cook this for about 1.5 hours on a 350 degree oven. You're gonna let it cook for 1.5 hours, and you want your meatloaf to reach an internal temperature once it's complete at 160 degrees. But we're gonna do it for 1.5 hours, then we're gonna add our delicious tomatoes on top and marinara sauce and some more delicious cheese. Okay guys, we're back. It's been about 1.5 hours. We're gonna check on this meatloaf. It has baked up beautifully. We still have some of those juices in there. Now, if you have too much juice, depending on what kind of mixture of meat you use, You can always drain a little bit out into your grease jar, but we're gonna always leave some in the bottom of the pan. Keep that moisture in. Now from here on out, we're not gonna cover our meatloaf. We're gonna take, I just have some jar marinara sauce I like to put on top, and remember how we saved those tomatoes. We're just gonna add it all together. Mix it up a little bit, and we're just gonna spread it all on top of our meatloaf. Also, if you have a lot, you can pour it all in the pan to get those flavors. So what is an Italian meatloaf without Parmesan cheese? So here I have some Parmesan cheese. We're gonna use a shredded Parmesan cheese, and we're gonna put a good amount right over the top. Then all we have to do now, we're gonna pop this back into the oven uncovered, because we want all that cheese to melt, and we want to heat up our marinara sauce and bake it right on top of that meatloaf. So we're gonna put it right back in the oven, uncovered. And we're just gonna wait about 20 more minutes. Then we're gonna check and see how good it looks. And just remember, putting that sauce on top is gonna keep your meatloaf moist as well while we have it uncovered. So now that it's been about 20 minutes to get that cheese all gooey and melty, we're gonna check it. Look at that beautiful meatloaf. Like I said, with that sauce and the tomatoes, all the moisture is gonna stay in there, so it's gonna be nice and moist. We're gonna let it cool off for just a few minutes, and then I'm gonna slice a piece off and we're gonna try it. So our meatloaf is cooled for just a few minutes. Now we're gonna cut it into slices. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put a slice right on my plate. So now we have a little piece of meatloaf on our plate, so we can sample it. Now if you want some of that extra sauce that you're gonna have in your pan, you can put it right there on top. Now it's time to try this delicious meatloaf. Nice and moist throughout. Since this is one of my favorites, I'm gonna try it first. Just how I always remember it tasting. Delicious. Now it's Shelby's turn. All right, Shelby, try that meatloaf.
Ten out of 10. I'm definitely going to try this again.
All right, guys, so there you have it. My favorite Italian meatloaf. Like I said, if you cook this on a Sunday, you're definitely gonna have leftovers. So Monday when you come home from work after the weekend, tired, homeschooling your kids, you got leftovers in the fridge. Once again, you're watching Cooking with Jen. I'm Jen. Be kind and subscribe.